Lugare, through which rivers flow. Oh, our Lord, forgive us our sins, accept our faith in the hereafter. Save us thee from the hellfire, admit us to Godhead, through which rivers flow, through which rivers flow.
This program is sponsored by the SPI Charity Foundation.
Sheikh, you said earlier that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be the first and the foremost person to enter paradise. Do we know about the last person to enter paradise?
Yes. In fact, there is one very interesting hadith that mentioned the last man to enter paradise. Again, if you recall when we mentioned as-sirat, we said people will be given light to cross as-sirat. And their speed will be according to the light they are given, because it's complete darkness. And we mentioned a man who is given very little light, and it's even blinking. Now that man will be crawling to cross the Sirat, and will probably be burned by the flames, and hurt by the clamps and hooks and so on. But he will eventually make it. When he makes it, he will look behind and be very grateful that he was saved from that, from passing on a sirat, from the fire. Then when he's in this position, he thinks that he is, the best man on earth, because he was saved from fire. And then he would see a tree, and he'll ask his Lord, "O Lord, just bring me to that tree so that I sit in the shade of the tree. I sit under the tree in the shade and drink from the water there." Allah will say, "If I give you that, will you be asking me for anything else?" He said, "No." And he gave, his promises had he will not ask for anything more. He just wants to reach that tree. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take him to that tree. Then he will sit in that tree under the shade, have some water. And after some time, he will see a better tree somewhere else ahead. And he'll say, "Oh Lord, bring me to that tree." And Allah will tell him, "Didn't you give me your promises that, you will not ask me for anything more?" He said, "Oh Allah, only to that tree." Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him only to that tree. He will sit there for a while, and then he will find a third better tree just next to the paradise. So he said, "Oh Lord, only to that tree." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "You did give me your promises, and now you're asking me for this again." But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will excuse him because of what he sees. So he'll bring him to that tree next to the paradise. When the man is sitting there, he starts hearing, the speeches of the dwellers of paradise. Then he'll ask his Lord, "Oh Lord, oh my Lord, just get me one step inside the paradise." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, "Okay, what would satisfy you? What if I give you something equivalent to the first life, your world life?" The man would say, "Oh my Lord, why do you make fun of me?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, "I'm not making fun of you. I'll give you 10 as much as well." That is the man who would be the last man to enter paradise. He would be received when he enters paradise. He will be received by two of the maidens, Al-Hur Al-Ain of Al-Jannah, and they will say, "Alhamdulillah, that brought you to us in paradise."
Sheikh, we hear about the 10 companions, Al-Ashr Al-Mubashirin, to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given the glad tiding that they will for sure enter Jannah. Isn't it that all believers will enter Jannah?
This is a very good question and very important to understand. We say yes. The rule is all believers enter paradise. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed. All believers will enter paradise. But when it comes to individuals, you know, Mr. So and so, then we cannot assure that this particular man is in paradise, because we don't know what's in the heart. We don't know the status at which he will die. So the rule is, yes, all believers go to paradise, but we cannot assure a particular one that he will be in paradise, except those whom have been, you know, named by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or by his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they will be in paradise. Among those are al-ashara, you know, the 10. And there are, in fact, others mentioned in other hadiths like Bilal and Haritha and so on.
So, Sheikh, now let's talk about the dwellers and the people who live in Jannah. How do they look like? What do they eat and drink? And what do they wear?
The Prophet ﷺ gave us some description about the dwellers of paradise. He said they will be in the most beautiful image and appearance of, and that is of Adam alayhi salam. Adam, by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him by his hand. So the people of paradise will be in the image and appearance of Adam alayhi salam, and in his size, 60 cubits. They will eat from wherever they wish. They don't need to urinate. They don't need to spit or blow their noses. So none of those dirts are there. They, you know, eat as they wish, drink as they wish. They are reclining on couches and cushions, and, you know, they have whatever they ask for and whatever they wish for. As for their dress, they will be given clothes from paradise. And the clothes in the paradise, by the way, the Prophet ﷺ was asked once by a man, are the dresses in paradise made or created? Are they tailored or created or what? The Prophet ﷺ said that the dress in paradise, the clothes in paradise, are, in fact, they, you know, they can be picked from trees. You know, the trees will, you know, bring out those dresses that the people of paradise can go and enjoy. And we were told about, you know, that's being silk, harir, or istabraq, and all those, you know, nice and soft textiles that the people in paradise are given.
Sheikh, will they have families in Jannah?
In Jannah, there is what we call al-hur al-ain. These are very beautiful women and ladies that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the dwellers of Jannah. And in the Quran, there are many nice descriptions have been given to those al-hur al-ain, like being lovers to their partners, being as beautiful and bright as berries and corals, rubies and corals. They are virgins. You know, all those nice descriptions. The Prophet ﷺ also said that if one of them looks from the heavens to the people on earth, then it will fill what is in between, light and nice perfume and smell.
Jazakallah khairan, Sheikh, and thank you again for sharing all the beautiful information with us.
Wayak inshallah, Abdul Jabbar.
So, dear brothers and sisters, here was Sheikh Dr. Ma'an Kusa with us talking about the blessings the dwellers in Jannah will receive. Please join us again in our next episode, where we'll continue asking the Sheikh about more blessings of Jannah and what happens when people be finally sent to Jannah. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله
وبركاته. This program is sponsored by the SPI Charity Foundation.
Through which rivers flow. Oh, our Lord, forgive us our sins, accept our faith in the hereafter. Save us thee from the hellfire, admit us to God through which rivers flow. Through which rivers flow.